YouTube, this is Andrea here. I'm losing my voice a little bit, so I may not do as much talking. You might want to turn your volume up really, really high for when I do some talking. So we're on the inside cover here. And this is a flip page. And it is 8 by 6 1/4. It's just a regular flip page with a little tuck spot here. And then we are also on the inside back cover. And that's just a little pocket with a little fancy punch, Martha Stewart punch. And it is 9 3/4 by 3 inches. That's that little tuck spot there. We are also working on the front cover. I have a little flip here. And it is 3 3/4 by 6 inches. Okay, let's go ahead and cut up some paper for our flip page. I'm going to use blue. This is Secret Garden. That says it all over the place on this side. And then, just a second. And then the side is just like little doilies. So let's use the doily side. Okay. Just want to mark it to cut to fit the flip. Cut that down. Piece right here, and we'll go through our scraps for that. These are too short. Well, that's perfect. It's perfect. So. I love that color. Of course, orange is my favorite color. Cut this piece at the end off. Do the same here. Alright, so we got our two pieces for the front. Now we're going to need a piece for this base and then the piece for the underneath here. Let's go with scraps again. We got this nice big one here. I can do this one at the bottom. Look at that. That fits perfect. So let's do that one. We'll do the top, and we'll go ahead and use the back of this paper for our top. So those are taken care of. We'll have to put a magnet here. Let's get that done before I forget. Tape. Always do about a half an inch from the edge of the page. Perfect. I also want to put a magnet on this flip. Okay. I have this chipboard piece, and it's going to go like this. So I'll put the magnet on here last. We'll see in a second. When we go to put the paper on there, we'll put those magnets on. Because I want to put it underneath the chipboard here and then have the magnet underneath there. Okay. Now we have to get paper for this side. Okay. Paper, paper. We have the secret garden. This way. Maybe I'll use this one. We're gonna go from edge to edge. First, let's get this up here. Let's mark our bottom. Okay. Slide that down. And mark our other side here. Now we can cut it down to come under here, like so. And we'll cut it a little bit here. That should be good to go. There's that. We need a piece for here. Get our scraps again. Orange. Let's go with orange and blue. In the front, we have blue and orange. So, go ahead and do the same in the back, except we're doing opposite on the colors. Perfect. So that is done. And I need the back. In the back, I think in the back, I have this here, or this here. I think maybe this wouldn't be better. Yeah, let's do it that way. It's a secret garden. I like that. That's gonna be our back. Okay, I got the front cut up. Let's get, I'm going to get everything inked up and stickified, and I'll be right back. Alright, we got everything ready to go for our paper. We got everything inked up. Excuse me. We've got our back piece. Put our back piece on. I'm using the art glitter glue. looks great. And we'll do our inside cover. We got this blue for here. Some orange for the top. And then our orange piece for the top. Push it down a little bit into the pocket. I like that kind of farmhouse-ish. It's cute. Like a little farmhouse. Then we have our tags that we cut out in the very beginning. And they can go in our little pockets. Like so. We have some, a couple of small ones. Not always nice. It's the fun part about these paper collections. You get so many goodies with them. Okay. Let's go ahead. There. Put this together. Start on the inside. We have this on top, and this piece. I'll do this piece here. Perfect. Then we have piece. Could go that way with it. Then I have this spot. It's like a mist punch. And I'm going to cover that with a little flower. But I'm going to use the white one. Glue on here so it stays stuck. And the little jewel came out. That's okay. I have some more jewels here. Maybe what I need is a pearl. I think I'm gonna use a pearl. Yeah, I like the pearl better. Put in a couple of these. This one here. We have these two left. And we'll find a place to put those inside the book. Quick fix. All right. It's nice and dry. Now, let's go with what we want to put here. So I know my paper for here is this one. Then I have a little piece that goes here. And I have a pretty piece, goes here. And we have this piece that goes here. That's our front for our paper. Now I've got these flowers. I would like to use, but I also have this flower that I would like to use. And where'd my little piece go? And we have this die cut that I want to use here. So let's put the die cut down first. That way they can use that to lift the flip up if they want. Gives it a little decoration. But I love this teal. I can't use all of these flowers. I wish I could. I may go ahead and take that off. And maybe do I don't know. I do have some lace with pearls. Let's think about putting on here. This might be too much. Let's start all over. Let's put our blue up. I love the blue. I love this really vibrant red. So, we gotta like those two. And I like this lavender. And then maybe do a few little rhinestones going up and around. Let's see. I know what to do. I have an idea. So I'm going to use these flowers still. But I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to put, see, we got to be careful because this opens and closes. So when you put your lace on, you're going to put it on the flip. So it goes with the flip, not against it. Got a little bit of lace on there with some pearls. And I like the flower up against the lace. Kind of like that. We got I like these teardrop ones. right? Go ahead and get our flowers down. Then I want to use this one. And this one. Oh, that's pretty. Pretty, pretty. Got a little bling. A little flower. I think it turned out really pretty. We do have the spine to do. I was thinking about leaving it black and putting a really pretty charm to hang off here. Let me look through my stash for charms. This is really pretty. These are all old broken jewelry pieces. This is gorgeous. Ooh, that kind of goes too. It goes with our colors. Let me see. Well, that's beautiful. So is this one though. Check that one out. I love them both. These are pretty. Okay. I like that one. That's perfect. We're going to stick with that. Okay. I'm gonna glue it down. I'm gonna remove the chain. And I'm gonna glue it down. Here and here. That's beautiful. I love that. All right. We found something for the sides. That is why I do all those jewelry jars. Because I always find something really, really awesome to put on the mini albums. So, if you're ever looking for extras to put on your mini albums, and you want it to be unique and different, get a jewelry jar. Start claiming some of those reclaimable jewelry pieces. Now we're going to let that dry up. I might even go ahead and use a little bit of the hot glue on that. So, I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. This is the last of this book. We will do a walkthrough later. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down below. And I appreciate anything you might have to say. Please forgive my voice. Hopefully it's back by next week. If not, it'll be just as quiet. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. Have a great one. Bye.